Hello everyone. Today we are going to solve some numerical problems, some simple numerical problems on measurement of three-phase power by two wattmeter method. So let me go to the first problem directly. So it has been given as a two wattmeter method. Let me read out. The power to a three-phase induction motor was measured by two wattmeter method and the readings were 3400 and minus 1200 watts respectively. Calculate the total power and power factor. So this is the, So moving on, let me say that I have the readings of the wattmeter as 3400 watts and minus 1200 watts respectively. Calculate the total power and power factor. If I want to calculate the total power and the power factor, I have the well-known equation, that is tan phi equals root 3 times W1 minus W2 divided by W1 plus W2. So phi is the phase angle and W1 and W2 are the wattmeter readings. For approximation, I will choose W1 equals 3400 watts and minus 1200 watts as W2. So now I need to calculate the total power which is being there and I need to calculate the power factor. So in order to calculate the second one, I need the phase angle, and if I take cos phi, it is the power factor that you get at the end. So next one, so let me move on to the solution quickly. Yes, so this is the solution for the given one, which is W1 equals 3400 or 3400 watts, W2 equals minus 1200. So minus sign indicates that it has been kicked back, and we will let you know in the laboratory what do you mean by kickback there. So tan phi is being given as root 3 times W1 minus W2 divided by W1 plus W2, and W1 minus W2, let me write it here. So 3400 minus of minus, it is plus, it is plus 1200. That is why we get it as 4600, and this is W1 plus W2. So W1 minus W2 is 4600, and W1 plus W2 is taken as total power. Let me highlight here, the total power is P, and it is also given as root 3 times VLIL cos phi. So VLIL cos phi, that is the power equation, and it is also given as the total power which has been there. So 3400 plus was there, that is generally the wattmeter 2 reading, which is negative. 3400 minus 1200, which is 2200 watt. So let me use this expression and take it down. So tan phi will be equal to 3.621, which is being present there. So next one I have, so you are left out with phi equals tan inverse of 3.621 and phi equals 74.56 degree, and power factor will be cos of phi, which is cos of 74.56 degree. So you are left out with cos phi equals 0.2661, so which is nothing but the power factor of a three phase AC circuit. So next one, I can generally go for the second problem. Let me read out the second problem. A balanced three-phase star connected load draws power from a 440 volt AC supply. The two wattmeters connected indicate W1 equals 4.2 kilowatt, W2 equals 0.8 kilowatt. So what you need to do, you need to calculate the total input power, power factor and current in the circuit. So total input power, let me write it here as W1 plus W2. Power factor can be calculated as cos phi, and current in the circuit. So look at the type of the connection. It is a star connected network. So for star connection, I have IL, which is the line current, that will be equal to IPH. So you can calculate it from the well-known equation of power, which is root 3 VL IL cos phi. So knowing the power, knowing the line voltage, which is 440 volt, cos phi is known to you, how you find out, and you can easily find out the unknown parameter, which is IL. So this is how the solution to the second problem looks like. Yes, this is the solution to the given problem. So let me list down the given data. So it's a three phase star connected load. W1 equals 4.2 kilowatt, W2 equals 0.8 kilowatt, and the total input power W1 plus W2 is 5 kilowatt, and power factor, which is cos phi. How do you calculate cos phi? So using this equation, what has been given there, you can calculate power factor. W1 minus W2, you'll get it as 3.4 kilowatt. So that has been there. And next one, moving on to the power equation, which has been there. Yes, this one, which is root 3 into 3.4 divided by 5. So 3.4 kilowatt divided by 5. Kilo, it is 10 power 3 and 10 power 3 cancels out. And you are left out with 3.4 divided by 5 that is being present there. So tan phi will be equal to 1.1776 and phi will be equal to 49.66 degree. So remember that this is the angle which is there in degree. Remember to change the calculator to degree mode if it has been kept in radian mode. So cos phi, cos of 49.66 degree. So you'll get it as 0.647. That is the power factor of a circuit which is being present there. So next one, how do you calculate the power in the circuit? Yes, you can calculate the power in the circuit as P equals root 3 VL IL cos phi. So this one, P is equal to root 3 VL IL cos phi. P will be equal to W1 plus W2 that has been given there. So this is how you can calculate IL. So for star connection, IL will be equal to IPH, which is 11.15 amperes. So P, which is 5000, this one is root 3 into 400 into 0.647. We'll get IL as 11.15, and this one is nothing but the phase current. So line current equals phase current in star connected network, which is 11.15 amperes. So this is how we can solve the second problem. Let me move on to the next problem, which is being present there. It's a third problem that we are solving. A 440 volt three phase AC motor has an output of 80 HP. Here the output is mentioned as 80 HP and operates at a power factor of 0.866 with an efficiency of 90%. Calculate the current in each phase of the motor if it is delta connected, and readings of the two wattmeters that has been connected in the lines to measure the input power. So as you can see, I've just highlighted here as 440, 80 HP, 0.866 and 90%. So whatever the power that was been there, which is P equals W1 plus W2. So this was being given as root 3 VL IL cos phi. So this is nothing but the input power that is being present there. So this is nothing but the input power, P equals W1 plus W2, that is root 3 VL IL cos phi. So next one, if I want to identify, yeah. So I'll list down the given data, which I told you earlier. And one approximation, what you can see here, which is the standard units of conversion. So 1 HP will be equal to 746 watts. So VL equals 440 volt, eta, which is the efficiency of the motor, which is 90%, cos phi, which is already being given, 0.866, power output in terms of kilowatt, which is 59.68 kilowatt. Okay, so next one, what you can generally do here is you can go for the phase current directly. So if you want to find out phase current, what you need to do? You need to find out line current first. So you have a well-known relation for delta. delta connected three phase AC motor. So IPH can be calculated as IL divided by root 3, and eta you can calculate it by P out, which is the power output, what I mentioned, somewhat around 59.68 kilowatt. So P input can be calculated. So P input is P output divided by eta. Substituting these values, you will get it as P in, which is 66.31 kilowatt. So P input is root 3 into VL into IL cos phi. IL, which is being given as P in divided by root 3 times VL cos phi, which is being present there. So next one, what I can generally come across is to find IL, and next one to find IPH. So this is how we can find out IL as 100.47 amperes, IPH, which is 58.010 amperes. So this is IL, IL divided by root 3, which is being given as 58.010 amperes. So next one, what you can generally come across is the power factor. Using the power factor, okay, yeah, let me write it here. Using the power factor, how do I calculate tan phi, and later on, how do I calculate the individual watt meter readings? So these are the steps that are being given. Phi is 30 degree, cos inverse 0.866. Use this equation and you will get tan phi as 0.5774. So this is W1 plus W2 that is being present there. Okay, so next one, what you can do here is, yes, next one, what you can do, so by using this one, W1 plus W2, and you get W1 minus W2, both set of equations you will get. So this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Solve 1 and 2. So solving equations 1 and 2, you will get the readings of the watt meter as 44, and the other term, which is 22.102 kilowatt. So those are the readings of the watt meter that is being present there. So next one, W1 equals 44.208 kilowatt, W2 is 22.102 kilowatt that is being present there. Okay, moving on to the next problem, the last problem for the day. I have three coils each of impedance 20 at an angle 60. Let me write down as 20 at an angle 60. It is being connected in star to 400 volt three phase 50 hertz AC supply. Find the readings on each of the two watt meters connected to measure the power input. So ZP, so that is the impedance in each phase. That is the impedance in each phase. So VL equals 400 volt, frequency is 50 hertz. What is W1 and W2? So that's what you need to calculate. So moving on to the next one, the solution part. So I have VL equals 400 volt, VPH is 230.94. IPH is being given as VPH divided by Z, which is 230.94 at an angle 0 degree divided by 20 at an angle 60 degree. This is Z. This is Z per phase. Let me write down again. I can write this one to be Z per phase also. So IPH is 11.54 at an angle minus 60 degree. So for a star connected network, IL equals IPH, that is 11.54 at an angle minus 60 degree. So tan phi will be equal to root 3 times, root 3 times W1 minus W2 divided by W1 plus W2. Again, using the same technique what we followed in the previous problem, we are having W1 minus W2 and W1 plus W2 as the same 4 kilowatt or 4000 watt. We'll be getting W1 as 4 kilowatt and W2 as 0 kilowatt. So this is the in detailed solution for the set of problems that we have solved. See to it that you solve more number of problems. I have given you 3 problems, which has been quite simple. Okay. So these are the simple problems, 5th, 6th and 7th. So solve these 3 problems, which are quite simple, and see to it that you get a better understanding of the 2 watt meter method topic, which is there in 3 phase AC circuit. Thank you, everyone.